Do it live. Do it live. It's alive. It's over on Find My Comic right now. Charlie Green live again. Yes. Hello, hello, hello. Yes, I sent that link to you over on Instagram. Shout out. Caleb in the house. Hey, Caleb. Kevin Davis with Arc Fire. Carrie has been pointing out his new live campaign, his new book, comic, said, yes, hey, I'm free April 12th, if that works for you. I just got back with him. So we'll see if he could come on at 4 Central if he needs another time. So that's good. He's been a bit sick. A few days ago, March 2nd, so hopefully he's over that. Been in correspondence for a while, apparently, so I try my very best. Mr. Shadowhawk, how are you?
Hola.
Hola.
What's happening, senor?
Trying to line up, talent. Rob says, okay, I have a few characters on the poster start. I'll send you this afternoon. Wow. God bless and happy Easter. When do you want to get together to chat? Now? I mean, anytime I'm available. Anytime.
What is Rex?
You not learn that by now? Huh?
I said, when are you not available? Huh?
Well, maybe not on Easter, but yeah, maybe. Yeah, I told him that I wanted to do a splash page because I do want him to do the interiors for, this will probably supersede and come out before even my next one that I'm wanting to do. I've been giving it some thought. Momentum Future Vision. So, Mrs. Good Stuff in the house. I did make meatloaf without meatloaf seasoning. They're kind of like mini meatloafs. And there were many of them. I think there were like 8 of them. I made about almost 3 pounds. That way I can freeze some of it. I can, you know, eat it at my leisure and have, you know, might as well, when you cook a lot, right? And so I made some meatloaf, put a little onion, a little turmeric in there, because that's good for you.
It's supposed to be.
Yeah. What else I put in there? Crackers. That's about it. Meat. Eggs. That's what keeps them tragic. Yeah. Anyway. Anyway, I thought he would do the interiors, and I came up with a new concept for a great cover for, and I'm so excited about that cover. It's like, yeah, maybe I need to do Daredevil. Not Daredevil. Shoot. How about Devil Flyer?
I was like, wow, he took a left turn there. Well,
yeah.
Where the hell did Daredevil come from?
Marvel. Well, the original Daredevil. No.
I don't think Bone Broth as well.
I think that was Lee Gleason Productions, right? Originally, maybe. I mean, Daredevil was created by, was it Chick Stone? Maybe.
I don't remember. Not sure.
Where's Mike when you need him to tell me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Moist or, meatloaf or dry meatloaf. Both are good. I agree. Turmeric is great for you. Start cooking with bone broth too. Yeah, I do that. I do that. Mm-hmm. Good for gut health.
Make my own bone broth.
Any
kind of bones.
Also
you
take
get,
collagen.
Whatever. Oh yeah.
I take the collagen tablets.
Yep, that's supposed to be good for you.
I'm out of my daily vitamins. I'm gonna have to get some vitamins, but I can.
Keep your fresh, milky white skin.
Racist. Anyway. Racism. Thanks for that, by the way. It keeps me honest. Oh, this is great. I've had a landslide, apparently, of drawings that I did.
Oh.
On thin paper. I don't think I've stepped on any of them to destroy thin paper. That's. Well, I think that one was like that anyway. When I began. Shall we begin? Oh man, I came down here yesterday really early. It might have been to get on with Russ and Randy and Glenn, you know, really early, like 4 a.m. And I was tight for time. And so it's like I have one of those rolly mats, you know, plastic mats, and it's all cracked. And I stepped on that, and oh man, you know, poking up. It's like, oh, what a great way to start the day. Ouch, that hurt. You know, 4 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah, that's only fun.
No, it wasn't much at all.
Yeah.
Shake it off. I know.
That's right. Be a man.
I am a man. Man with a plan. As you well know. And, yeah, I might have to, you know, follow up Devil Flyer by IP with the zero issue. The story now, I don't know, but I want to do the, and I don't know what I want to put on the splash page. But I want to do the opposite of what John did before, which was a burst through cover.
Okay.
So tell me,
do a burst in cover?
Well, it's going to be the medieval. It's going to be the medieval. Well, let me just bring the campaign up and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Everyone. Help you realize.
It's going to be him bursting back through. All you're going to see is elbows and buttholes.
Well, yeah, it is kind of almost a course, through back in. Yeah. So you have the medieval armored here. I think we could do a story with him. I think people would like to see that now that he's been created, right? By the way, if you, I mean, we, I know nobody cares about this anymore, but anyway, we've only got 3 days to go on the campaign. And I tell you what, I gave serious thought to just shutting this campaign down, like doing a John Malin and not going into man. But I won't do that. Huh?
Yes, it's certainly up to you, sir. It's your campaign.
Right. Yeah. 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 I really thought about just shocking people and just, okay, it's gone. You know, we'll get on with the business of getting the book done. I will keep it in demand, though. We will go in demand. But I really, really did give it some thought. If I didn't need the additional money right now, I would just say the hell with it and shut it down. You either got it or you didn't. And it might not be in demand very long because I'm getting ready to start to work. Keep it in demand. Be a man. Good stuff says. Phantasmagorical in the house. Hey, Fanta. Rex, do you have an email list that you message regularly? Yes, I have a Gmail. It's under Rex.
By the way, I wanted to double check. Is your address? Never mind. I wouldn't do that to you.
It's under RexAllenChristian@gmail.com. That's no secret. Okay. So with that business out of the way, so my here is
ooh, business.
Yeah, so in from the bottom right hand corner, and this is all I got on that, you know, okay, but he would be coming in punching Devil Flyer, right? And he would be going back, you know, into the cover and pulling and ripping it off the spine here.
Oh,
so the cover would be giving away like a sheet.
Right.
Huh? Like, and you would see
reality with him.
You would see, yeah, you would see Rob's splash page art around the edge. So that's why we need to do this. Huh?
That's a cool concept. I like the idea.
I know, and it will pull the Devil Flyer logo. Yeah. It'll be ripped. It'll be rippled.
Make it stretch.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I've been thinking these things.
I like it. I like the idea.
I do too. Yeah. I guess I should be saying hi, Mom. Laugh out loud.
Just goes to show Rex is not a puddinhead like our illustrious leader.
Oh, are you emailing your sign up list? Well, I mean, we're live. We've got 3 days left on the campaign. Sign up list is no more. It's launched. This is the campaign here over on Fund My Comic. 51 backers, really 50 backers, because I don't count myself as one. $2,963, but I guess I count. 3 days to go. So we'll be having a closeout stream here pretty soon. Tapestry, you know, we'll have the Jimmy Reyes cover here pretty soon. Standy, this will be the Standy right here on the left. The image from the cover.
Jelly Bean.
Hardback, you can get all three covers. Here's the number one cover by John Dillard, number two from John Fernandez, and then Jimmy Reyes. Blank variant, you've saved $5. Great for sketching on. Wraparound cover, so you can do a big wraparound cover blank. Digital edition, which will have additional material. By
that midnight was George, right? Was that?
Yes, that's George Peter Gaddis, yeah. Right there. that'll be our next stretch goal. If we reach the zigzag magnet, and I'm pretty confident we will. This is John Dillard, and then this is George Peter Gaddis there, the modern day mummy. First piece I had him do. That's where some of the campaign funds, you know, to bolster and put some fuck color images up here, and these will be in the book. So, and they're not just pinups. These are going to be somewhere put in the book. I have an idea for this bystander piece, how to do it, how to frame it, make it look dope. Digital edition will have additional material in it, what the artist edition, and maybe some extra get drawn in tier. We have the original Bog artwork up there for $200. That's an original acrylic painting by Doc Blaylock. We have the title page and a great action page here where the clown gets his up there for sale. Another yeah. Doc Blaylock devil flyer he wanted to do him, so there he did. And then the great shot that'll be in the book of the bystander hanging from a web. What's that all about? Well, it'll be alluding to another story, I'm sure. The director, I was kind of reticent, but kind of art poor, you know. And
see what it is.
Take a good look, because you know you only see him in shadow. You don't really see him for a while. So, and then we have a unknown vampire character here, which will be featured maybe in this headshot, because I like that really well. Heap Golden Age, some artwork of mine. Nobody loves my art, so I haven't sold it, but that's fine.
Pitchforks blowed into your eyeball, but I love it. This is good stuff.
Additional artwork here, strong imagery of the bystander, think, and the vampire and slaver, and all done by Doc. Here's our next stretch goal right there, zigzag magnet, $3,050. This will be the content page done by John Dillard here, this typewriter, and Hutch and everything will be on the inside front cover. I think I said inside back cover last time. I get those confused. Everybody gets a 6 a.m. sticker. You're going to get a full trading card for signing up if you did indeed sign up and back the book. You're going to get this image of the medieval armor there, which will be on the next cover of the Devil Flyer Zero. It'll probably won't be a 48-pager, but the price will come down too. You'll also get this shattered sort of reality or glass piece, you know, of bystander on a card. If you have already backed and you donate $1 to the campaign, I've had a couple people take me up on that, and that's all. That's all right. These things will be exclusive, so I can probably print about 25 of them and be safe. I'll probably print more than that, but I don't know. They're promo cards. Don't need a lot of them, so I may not print a lot. You may have one of 25 printed. You know, I don't ultra care. Rare. It's like, ultra rare. So get yours today before it closes down. We're down to the last 3 days.
Malin looked like a piker.
Yeah, the ash can and all that was rare. I mean, all those cards were tacked on. I think I wrote down, you know, one of them was less than 100, and then I spilt some soda on some and ruined some of the cards. So they're only rare. Yeah.
It was an accident.
Hey, Harry. Miss Good Stuff is in here with Carrie, so the chat is hopping today.
Yes.
Kind of like these pop-ups for me.
Eric and Timothy both in the chat. Hail, Eric. What's up, buddy? What's up, Timmy?
Miss Good Stuff says cover ideal puts spring loaded pitchfork confetti behind the cover. like they do those greeting cards with butterflies. Yeah.
Yeah. There's a little glitter confetti. Pitchforks can come out and stab you in the eyes as you open your comic.
And then you'll never read again, and I'll get sued. Good one. We got another here.
Everybody gets to read it, love, man.
I mean, I'm getting your friend Arcfire on in April, maybe. Let me go over here.
April 12th, I think it was, Rex, according to Carrie.
Okay, that's another campaign. I'm talking about Arcfire. He just got back with me on Instagram and wants to come on. What was it? 12th, maybe? I'm not sure.
Sometime
in April. He's got to confirm the time first, or I might have to do. Oh, Kevin Davis. Okay, this is his Arcfire. Okay, I don't need to go and do all this. That's okay. I hear you have a special guest. Maybe. I mean, he's clear for that. I don't know the time yet. If it'll be on the 4 o'clock shadow, if it'll be earlier, later. I don't know what time zone he's on. So that has to be. Can't wait to get my physical copy of this. Love your art, Rex. I know you do.
Oh, God.
I love my art, too. I'll keep it. And then when Devil Flyer just, I'm telling you, man, this. Momentum Comics is going to take off at some point. I'm sure of that. And I know this is my first concern, and I don't mean to sound conceited or anything, but it's like, yeah, I know what I'm capable of. And just like this other cover ideal, you know, with John Dillard and whatnot, we'll make this work. People will be going, wow, man, this is, you know, and I'm sorry, I didn't get in on, you know, and I didn't get these ultra rare, you know, that's fine. You know, less for me to produce. I'll get mines as a, you know, I'll get my copy. I'll get everything that I produce, you know. And then when I'm so old and want to retire and get on a respirator, I'll sell my collection, but maybe. Yeah, you know, an heritage auction or something. I don't know. If I had better parents,
Rex is going to hire me to rent out of a bulldozer.
Oh, your art, Rex. Well, thank you, Miss Good Stuff. And I know that you waited for your tax season. I think I did too. I mean, the way the economy is, you know, I wanted to lodge tax time. I did with my ash can as well. I think it's the best way that's least hurtful to people. But I would like to do. I would like to do more than one book a year. So, but it may, you know, if you want to wait till next February for me to launch Devil Flyer Zero, then maybe I can make it thicker. I don't know. I don't know what the count would be. I know what I said. I'm thinking 24 pages or something. I don't know. I'm trying to get out more product. You know what I mean? But good. And Rob Ewing would be doing the inside with John Dillard cover. I do want John to do this cover because I think he could pull it off really well. And I think it would be a good bookend to this cover. It being a zero issue, I might even make it magazine size like this one if people like the magazine size, you know. Eric and Boyd, hello. If you haven't smacked that like button, please do, for somebody else's sake besides my own.
A zero issue, Timothy. What?
Wow, man. Really? It's amazing. People get into the chat and they make sexual innuendos. I was only joking. Oh, okay. I mean, I did the same thing, but I mean.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know either.
You know, it's like.
I saw nothing sexual.
I was crying, laughing, reading Easter eggs. Okay. Have been renamed just gesture eggs, make them sound unsuitable for kids. Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, I hadn't heard about all that. Don't want to, actually. There's all kinds of
stupidity going on.
Oh, yeah, there is. My advice is just go out and get laid, I guess. Hashtag blame PayPal. And yes, Eric and Boyd, you will be getting the special cards because you are the total mystery tragic meatloaf winner. You get everything in this campaign. Now the next one you will not, you know, unless I run another campaign. And Lorenzo gets the mystery gift. He'll get some dope stuff too. I'll make sure he gets those limited cards too. But other than Shadowhawk and Bone, no one's taken me up on the dollar, you know, if you've already backed. And let's see. Trying to catch up here.
I don't know what's going on. Chat's going crazy. And there's a whole other subject we haven't even approached yet.
The Buzzkill Show. Oh, okay. I would, yeah, I guess. I mean, you know, I don't even want to go there. You wouldn't let me contribute a dollar. I know. We're good. We're good, Carrie. You're good. You're farmed in. You got one. So no need. Oh, Rexy Sexy. Sexy Rexy. Yeah, Carrie. Yeah. That's harsh, Timothy. I never know what is going on.
That's how I feel pretty much.
Yeah, me too. I mean, you know. But yeah, the new John. What do you think about that? A quick, lower count, lower price, Devil Flyer Zero issue. Rob Ewing artwork with John Dillard cover, where he's getting knocked into the cover, and it's ripping away from the, around the edges, and you see the artwork from the splash page.
Again, I like the concept for the cover and all that.
And he'll go up against the medieval.
Just trying to keep up with you, Rex. That's all.
I know. Well, I'm trying to get product out like Timothy, you know.
Well, you know what? I mean, you know, not getting product out there, Eric July. It's making good content that people will enjoy.
Well, I think, yeah. Oh, well, I don't know what to say to that. I mean, exactly. I agree with it. As if I wouldn't give you quality product. I got it. Anyway, moving on.
Again, you're using the wrong terminology. It makes it sound bad. That's all.
Oh, okay. Maybe.
If it's just product to you, then. Why should anybody else take it?
It's not just product to me. You know that.
I know that, but then don't talk about it that way.
Okay. Well, I'm just trying to get. Okay. Did I say just get product? Okay. It's just trying to get some quality reading into people's hands. How's that?
See, that's better.
As quickly as possible. I mean, if you've got a John Dillard cover and Rob Ewing insides, he's going to knock it out of the park. We'll get to see, if those two pinups of the beefy looking, that'll be quite a battle, I'd love to see how he just battles the medieval armor, and then that'll bring the director, the shadow government in it, who's pictured on the campaign. Because he's all behind that. I always had this, I had this called like Red Robot. I have my own government now. Huh? What?
I said I have my own government now, the shadow government. I like it.
Yeah, mass quantity means nothing to me, right? Quality is best, right? I hope everyone has a great weekend. Whatever your plans may be, he is risen. Absolutely. Rex, I think you have a fantastic book. So you got this shit on lock. Okay. That's right. I can't believe Easter is here already. Tree Goblin in the house saying, Oi, tree.
Man, to anyone who understands, Christos on the.
Okay, I'm leaving. Because I didn't understand that.
Means Christ is risen.
That, okay, that's yeah.
Technically, a little bit early should be tomorrow.
That was Latin, right?
It's rooted in Romanian, as far as I know. I grew up Romanian Orthodox.
No, Eric, no, that's how. The Romanian is
probably rooted in Latin. So
I probably have meatloaf to let you know on Easter. Because I made it. I probably had some more meatloaf for sure tonight. The gift that keeps on giving. Shh, don't tell Rex, but I just contributed $5. Shh, don't tell. Well, thank you for that, Gary. Let's bring it up here then, and let's take a look, and let's renew this thing and watch it jump, shall we? $2,963.
Jump.
It says 1 month. No. Almost 2 months. That's wrong. Anyway, okay, so 2963. Let's watch it jump by $5. Thanks to Carrie.
Yeah, Carrie.
That'll help keep us trending on the front page, I believe. So, okay. Did it go up? I think it did, right? 63 to 68. There we go. Getting so close to $3,000, which is getting us closer at 3,050 to this piece right here by Rob. Wow, that's a long campaign there. There we go. The zigzag magnet. I'll probably pay a little bit more for these. These aren't, I can actually get the magnets done fairly reasonably. I don't know if they can do a long magnet, but if they can do a longer magnet, which I think they can, this thing's going to be long, you know, to show a slipstream. It's going to be big.
Well, like I said, though, dude, even if you just did them business card size, it would still be pretty cool.
No, that's too small. We're going to do it bigger than that.
I know.
I'm going to spend some money on this campaign. You're going to get quality. This is going to be put a pin in it.
I know I'm going to get quality. I would like you to be able to keep on doing this somehow. But
all right. Now, believe me, I'll be able to afford it. Director will be in that, he'll be the protagonist. That kind of links up Inner Man, because he's kind of an Inner Man protagonist, although he's a Devil Flyer protagonist too. He'll be there at the apocalypse.
Wouldn't he be the antagonist, Rick?
Okay, whatever.
I'm just saying.
You're the protagonist right now. So we're $82 to stretch go.
No, me.
Yes, I believe so. We're pretty close to the stretch go.
The protagonist is the hero. The antagonist is the bad guy.
I've got a rash and I just can't get rid of it. Damn, it found it. I don't know what that was. I swear I don't snitch. I rebelled. Mahahaha. You're really nice to Rex, Gary. He does not deserve it. Ooh, cut me to the quick. I'm headed to a baseball game later. Gonna be cold. Ooh. Yeah. It's gonna be cold here as well. But not too cold. It's up in the 70s. I think tomorrow will be high 77 here. At least pretend to tell me off, Rex. Okay, Gary, please don't ever do that again. Till next time. If I tell you off strong enough, will you get $5 more? I found it funny. Gable. Good drink. Years passed behind my house here. As I said, they used to drop Easter eggs from helicopters for the kids. And then they would try to get them. Huh?
So right on their poor little heads.
Yeah, unbold.
They're looking up, going, oh, look, right in the eye.
And then a big banner would end Farrell.
Did you answer Mrs. Goodstuff's question there, Rex? Are we only $82 away from the next stretch goal?
I did. Or, yep, sure did. Okay. Yep. 2 minutes.
That's awesome.
I mentioned it. Yep. Anyway, I was going to tell a joke. It's yeah, shot
exactly to hell right now.
Huh? It was an old man's yep. joke anyway. Not to sound like your mom, but you stream so much, it should be pinned on every stream. Like, well, I do have it down in the description.
And put it up pinned at the top of the chat. It's easier.
Okay. People like easy yeah. peasy. Okay.
Easy to access.
I can go do that now. Sure. I mean, I did it the there other day. I just don't consistently do it. But yeah, I can do that.
Eric, exactly. No, he only ignores the good ones.
I'm moving slow. I'm not zigzag. So it may be I'm just not keeping up.
You know we love you, Rex.
I don't think I could survive anything else.
Fanta says, pin it. Do it already.
Yeah, but that damn heart and emojis gets in the way. Now, it does.
Hey, Mrs. T, get him.
All right. Pin. it has been pinned.
Love it.
Yep. But now I'm going to say, do it or you're grounded, son. Okay. I did it. Thank you, Caleb, as usual.
Caleb,
I got it right there. All hopefully right. It's a good link. Somebody see if that's a good link that I pinned. Hopefully it is. Some people have been saying some of my links have been not good. Yeah, it's in the way. I don't know how to get rid of that emoji thing. The heart emojis are at the bottom of my phone. Yeah, it's different on your phone.
Yeah. It pops like up like in the corner. There is a way to get rid of it, but I always get rid of them accidentally.
I don't ignore every suggestion. I don't even ignore my...
No, you only ignore the good ones.
Easter eggs are now like jester eggs, according to UK News. A jester egg. Make a good jester, I guess.
Yeah. Throw an egg at somebody.
I would arrive in a jester suit. You know, a joker jester.
And I would just start throwing eggs at people.
Exactly. And then you get sued because somebody would say,
oh, I'm allergic to eggs. I had to go to the hospital.
Right. It'd take less than that.
Probably. Probably be like an attempted murder with a boiled egg.
Mrs. Goodstuff says, good job, Rex. You can go to the party with your friends.
Oh.
Figure it out, Gable. Shadowhawk, do you have your action Bible? Oh my God. Don't ever tell her if you got it or not. Don't tell her.
I'm the wrong person.
That is for disobeying me, young lady, and contributing. Being rebellious.
See what happens, Carrie? I get punished.
Oh, there you go. Eric and Boyd says, paint the eggs with male and female symbols and see the alphabet crowd lose their minds. Some plonker.
I almost spit my drink.
Are a Christian thing. Yeah, they're not. They're a pagan thing about fertility. Why don't we just hand out dildos and have the kids search after dildos and vibrators?
Easter eggs have never been a Christian thing anyway. I don't see why anybody's making a big deal about it.
No, and Christmas trees were actually, when they first came out, were turned upside down. Yes, did you know that?
Was all taken, I was adopted from pagan tradition as well. It was, they just combined everything together to make it easier for people to get along.
What's pot? What's pot? I mean, I know what smoking pot is, but trying to turn me on, you pot. Turn me on, you pot. paint their pronouns on the edge.
I think maybe chick, that was chick. A misspelling.
Chick, chick. Shadow, do you need my address? Fantas says.
No, I got it. That's why I was messing around earlier. I was like, let me confirm. Is it? I'm not going to say that out loud.
Sauce pot.
But no, you sent that it to me alluring. In sauce my messages. Pot. I found it. So sauce. You should have a graphic novel coming to you shortly, my dear. Now, are you still going even with everything that fucking happened? I mean, we haven't approached this subject yet.
Who are you talking to?
To Fanta. She's, I think, going to CTE2.
Let's see. What the hell was I going to do? Bring something up. Oh, yes. Fund my comic. There's Mike Walters when you need him. Hello, Mike.
Hello, Mike.
Fanta says, I don't think that's how dildos work, Rex. I mean, it's a fertility ritual. Well, that could get the meatloaf going. I'm just saying. give me lish. Emotional diamonds.
The hell?
Okay. I know what I was going to do.
Why do I come here every day? What the hell?
What, you want an explanation of what, you know, why you come here every day? Really? You're going to ask the hard question?
Obviously, I need to be locked up.
They're coming to take me away, ha-ha, hee-hee, to the funny farm where life is beautiful.
In a can here in Alabama? What?
Well, thanks to Carrie, I believe, we're trending number one over on Fund My Comic and others. And hopefully
basically, they kicked Shane, John, and Ethan off the sales floor. They banned them from the
website. Go to Fund My Comic again. I'll see if I'm still trending number one or if it reshuffles the deck.
I was even thinking about pulling out my bulletproof vest and heading up there, but that's not going to happen now.
Oh, my God.
The Chicago Comic Con just fucked over CG in a huge way.
How?
We're like 6 years into this mess, and everybody thought it was settling down, but nope.
Okay, how did this happen, and where did you learn about this?
This has been apparently happened at some point last night. It's been all over the internet since I woke up this morning or before I went to bed last night. The people running C2E2, the Chicago Comic Con, have had a contract with Shane, John, and Ethan technically just with Shane and Yanzi, because they, according to their rules, only one LLC can rent the booth. But they have 11 passes. They can invite whoever they wanted to, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So Shane, John, and Ethan were all going to be at Chicago Comic Con, first big con that a bunch of CG guys have been at in, you know, since COVID. And Chicago Comic Con called and shut them down, told them that they had violated their terms of service somehow. And
they didn't give them a reason.
And their booth has been pulled. They're not going to be allowed to be exhibitors at the show. Wow. I guess John and Shane are still talking about going anyway and like hooking up with people outside of the show or something. But as far as I'm concerned, I wouldn't even do that. It's a bad idea. Something bad's going to happen. It's fucking bullshit. Anyway.
Well, I wouldn't broadcast that I'm coming. And I don't know. Yeah, they could probably be escorted away by security. I know that
Well, besides, I mean, it's the fucking losers that hate CG are already taking this as a win. They're all, you know, out there going, ah, fucking bigots don't get to come to.
Yeah, what a big win.
Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
But, if you know, if you go and show up anyway, and then you're like, then they can have somebody, like, get footage of you meeting up outside the con with fans. And look how desperate they are, you know, just spin shit, you know, and make it look even worse. It's just
Mrs. Goodstuff wants to know, so did they refund the campaign money or just keep going on with the book? Sounds messy. No.
I know. So that's the other thing, too. They ran a whole, you know, campaign to do the books for this con. People are supposed to be going and getting their books, meeting everybody, getting signed stuff. I mean, I guess the books from the campaign are going to get mailed anyway, but I don't know. It's a mess. It's all fucked up.
The money really wasn't tied to the con. Exactly. That's, yeah.
No, I mean, what do you call it? Shane and Yanzi had already paid for the booth and stuff like 5 months ago. It's been taken care of for months and months in advance. Right.
I do like the idea they could rent a separate thing and have their own mini con and signing and whatnot.
Yeah, but again, that's been suggested by people that hate CG in a sarcastic manner. Why don't you just do what other people have to do when you can't get into one of our events? Ha ha ha. You know, it's
right.
It's just a bad fucking look. That's all.
Okay. So what I say is next year, run concurrent with it, bigger and better than they are.
Yeah, I just say we do our own thing. But I don't know why.
Let's have a CG convention. Let's have a CG convention with all the creators, just like we talked about early on, right?
We've been talking about that for like 4 years now.
I know.
Why?
We could do it
opposite. If we just do that, then we don't have to worry about the rest of these fucking assholes.
And do
just
it. Like, I really don't want to go to Chicago to do it right now. The way
it's like Luke started Fund My Comic. That way we don't have to worry about being shadow banned. We don't have to worry about fucking people sticking their faces in going, ew, you're not right. We don't like your humor. What? No, fuck you guys. We're doing our own things. We're doing it without you.
Miss Goodstuff said, I thought I heard a long time ago the big guys talking about doing their own completely. Yeah, whatever happened to that?
Exactly.
It got shunted back. They got behind. It wasn't a big party. Malin.
COVID.
Did Malin do his?
Malin COVID was talking. You know, it was going to be the big CG convention back, you know, in 2020 when it first started being talked about. But, oh, well.
They better get, they paid $10,000 plus for that booth. What the hell? $10,000 bucks?
Yeah. Just to rent the fucking floor space, dude.
Well, if they don't, I would sue them, you know.
Yeah. And what about all the people who bought tickets to C2E2 that wanted to come out there and meet Shane or John or Ethan? Are they allowed to sue? Now I want my fucking money back, because the reason I was coming, I rented a hotel room, I bought a plane ticket, or I had to drive. I mean, that's bullshit, man. People plan this months in advance and invested money, put down deposits on hotels.
Jolly Green says their booth was 20 feet by 20 feet. It was massive.
Yeah, it was going to be huge. It was one of the biggest sales booths on the floor. And everything was cool up until like 48 hours ago, something like that. All of a sudden,
Tree Goblin says a guy in Ethan's chat spent $2,000 on tickets and hotels.
Mm-hmm. A bunch of people have. I mean, for me, I could just jump in the car and drive up there. It still cost me a couple $100 for tickets, though, to go in for the day.
Oh, yeah. And I've been up there a couple times. You know, I've talked about it in 85, 86, and how it has changed. I wouldn't go up into the Chicago area now. I'm like you. It's too damn violent.
As I said, dude, I was good, but for this, I was thinking about strapping on my fucking bulletproof vest and heading on up there.
But sure. I mean, if they've got a massive thing, you can meet up with them and, you know, and they probably need the love anyway. But I imagine that there would be a lot of people lined up to, you know, get autographs and whatnot. And
but especially now, like, even if I would really advise John and Shane not to. You don't want to be meeting up outside of a controlled space in Chicago in this time of our nation, guys. It's a bad idea. Just stay home.
Fanta says, I heard someone tried to get their money back, but they wouldn't give them a refund.
No, of course not.
Crazy city right now. Yeah. I'll hold your hand, Rex. Thank you, Tree Goblin.
Yeah, that's a chance. I mean, it's only like 40 minutes for me, but I haven't been in Chicago in 12, 13 years. It's just not worth it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a shame, man. You know? Again, here we are nearly 6 years. The CG has been going on.
The crowd doesn't let it go.
No, they don't let it go. Once you've been branded, you've been branded for life.
Branded. I was, you know, the same guy that did Branded did, The Invaders. I just listened to a commentary on one of the episodes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's pretty wild. Those are like very, very opposite ends of the spectrum.
Yeah, right? Yeah. And he said that Chuck Connors was conservative, you know, and was, he almost ran him down with a horse. He had a whole story about Chuck Connors and being on the, you know, the lot and almost getting ran down. Shadow Kingdom by our friend Russ.
Russ Lee?
$1,817. Yes.
Very nice.
Butch Cleaver, 1 and 2. All right. Finally got some movement on this. It's $130. Two backers.
All right.
Let's
there
watch
we go.
The trailer, shall we? Wait, I regret this already, but all right.
Only on Chubby Ass Theater.
I mean, that's what... Okay, all right, here we go. Damn.
Now, metal movie from Bruce's. Just let it go.
Is that music? Oh, my God. Okay, here we go. Buy my book. Buy my book. Buy
Shut
my
up and
book.
Let go. If only I had the phone party. This is good stuff. So it's a beautiful motel set to leave light on for you.
Now, is this is not copyrighted music, right? I'm not going to get struck for it.
I think this is a friend of Matt's or something, or maybe even his own band. I'm not sure.
Okay.
But no, you're not gonna get struck for it. Unless Matt strikes it. Back. Probably missed you.
Did Luke do that poster? He did some work for the campaign, Death Metal Hero.
I'm not sure. I know he did do some work for Matt, but I'm not sure which pieces.
Mm-hmm. You get to have the origin of Butch Cleaver. That's cool. You know, sometimes that's necessary. I think, I know he did some trading card artwork. So there's Luke's trading card artwork.
Damn, Tree. Look.
Wanted poster, but it doesn't say who did the artwork. Yes,
poster you taking, dude.
What did he say?
He said he stayed in a hotel in Bulgaria or something that was being secretly filmed for Hotels from Hell or some shit like that. Some kind of wacky TV show.
All right, you go to some of these foreign countries, you better not undress because they'll probably get it on film, you know. Then they'll sue you for a broke camera.
Okay.
Funded a $5 go. Wow. So he put it up for $5. I thought it was more than that. I thought he had it up for $500. They must have changed that.
I don't know. Don't remember. I know this was the second chance that he already.
Right. Yeah, but I think he had a $500 go. I think he must have had them reset that, but seeing as it was, you know, no backers. And then, but he had a lot of time left on it. So I'm not saying he wouldn't have got funded, but.
Yeah, and unfortunately, I didn't do the FMC campaign because I backed him so heavy on Indiegogo.
Mr. Burger's cartoon comedy
character. Yeah, he's gonna work out.
Here. A toothbrush? What am I supposed to do with a toothbrush?
Hey, no, Mr. you'll G. figure it out.
Oh, hell.
I don't like this place, Burger.
Keep it together, guys. You need to...
Hey, watch it, six-legged asshole. You almost hit Mr. Big Stabby.
Why do they call you Big Stabby?
What you think, Esse? I love stabbing people. I stab men, I stab women, I stab dogs and kittens. But what I really love is stabbing old people. I come from a long line of stabbers, man. My dad was a stabber. My granddad was a stabber. My great-granddad before him was a stabber. Hell, my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-uncle stabbed Christopher Columbus in the ass. Why'd you think he come to America, huh?
So you better stay out of the way of Mr. Stavi.
Later, Chomos.
You know what? I think that guy might just stab us.
Really, you think?
I don't want to be stabbed.
Nobody wants to be stabbed, you sissy. Besides, we have other things in here to be worried about.
Like what?
I don't know, another type of stabbing. And not with a knife, if you know what I mean.
Oh. What? No!
Yes!
We need to get the hell out of here.
Your donut's already got a hole.
Hey there, Tater. What do you say there? You want a beer? You want a cold one?
Sure, Burger. Why the hell not?
I tell you what, there, Tater. You got a fine group of young Americans this year.
Great. A real fine group of young Americans. Check this out. Hey, Jimmy. You take that bat and show us what you got now.
No problem, Coach.
Hey!
See? He's much better now. Last week, he got me in the nuts.
Oh my god, dog. Go away. I don't have time for your,
Listen to me, you climate-denying heteronormative piece of crap. Because we only have 12 days until the world ends. What we're going to do is... No more trains. No more cars. No more planes. No more cows.
Sweet merciful Jesus, what fresh hell is this?
No more cell phones. No more food. My personal favorite, no more farts. No more air and, well, just die. If we're not willing to roll over and die as a people, there's no way the human race can survive.
What? What the f***? Bitch, are you for real?
This is goddamn ridiculous. I mean, I've been at home for almost 20 minutes. What the hell's going on here? Music's okay though. I like the 80s. It's good stuff. Yeah, I love this song. I almost hope they don't answer. Hello, hello. Is this customer service? Is this customer service? Listen, thank God. What the hell's going on here? Are you people asleep? I don't want to hear that. Look. There's a problem with my order. Listen to me. I ordered the female blonde Kimmy model 139 sex doll. Right? What I received was the male redhead Kenny model 121A sex doll. All right? For sex. What do you mean, what the hell are you watching? Clearly, ma'am, I ordered a female and I received a male. I would like this situation rectified, please. I have things to do. What do you mean, am I homophobic? Look, lady, I'm not a fan of penises. I have one, but it's purely functional. Wait, why, what? Excuse me? That's none of your goddamn business whether I enjoyed the complimentary pre-lubed anal beads that came with this particular model. All right, it's supervisor time, bitch. Let me speak to your supervisor. Oh, God. Oh, God, lady, I don't like dicks.
Well, tomorrow we'll be it's turning the person. Like
if I'm being honest, I'm not into the shape of them. It's not appealing to me.
Everybody feels like all dicks.
They look like undecorated Christmas trees, as far as I'm concerned. I don't care if there's a 30-day return policy if I'm not completely satisfied. Trust me, bitch. I'm not gonna be satisfied. Can we just fix this or what?
You like some sauce with that burger?
God, I love showering. I love being clean. Dub, 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 dub.
Sally lollipop, hell pop. I like them all.
Well, let's see what we got here.
So basically, he's a bun.
Right. No.
No.
Hell no. I'm out of here.
Hey, what the heck? What's going on? Like, where you going? Dog. Hey, no. Listen, I did this for you. You know, it's a this is a hey. Oh my god.
Oh my god. I owe you, Mr. Burger. Appreciate you letting me show off your stuff without striking rights.
Hello, and welcome to Melvin's Tech Support. How can I help you today?
Hello. Yes. My computer isn't working.
Okay. Could you give me your name, and I'll find you on my system?
It hasn't been working since I got the damn thing.
Yes, I understand. Could I just have your name, please?
I see. You must be too busy to remember your best customer. It's Karen Cupcake.
Bitch, are you for real?
Ah, yes, I found you on the system. I see you bought a desktop computer from us recently. Now, could you tell me if it's plugged into the wall socket?
Do you think I'm some sort of idiot, like all your other customers? Of course it's plugged into the wall.
Could you tell me what happens when you hit the power button on the front of the case?
I've already told you. Oh my god, are you high? Nothing damn well happens when you hit this stupid little button.
Okay, if you look at the back of the computer where the power goes into it, do you see a switch?
Wait, what? Is there a switch on the back as well?
After being thoroughly rejected by every single woman in the club, Mr. Burger talks to his friends for moral support.
Sweet Jesus, that was painful to watch.
I'm gonna have to be honest with you, Burger. That was terrible, disgusting, embarrassing. And that's coming from someone who loves you like a brother.
Are you kidding? Oh, God, really?
Right.
And that's coming from one friend to another.
Pause for a second.
True.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I was listening to the wiener.
I understand that. It's just making me feel a little weird playing someone else's content that long without a break and without saying anything about it. I'm sure Mr. Burger appreciates it, but I don't know. Just
I thought it was their trailer on Fun My Comic.
Is that that's just the trailer?
It's yeah, it's trying to put on the campaign. Yeah.
Okay. I thought you were showing like multiple episodes of little short cartoons, dude. It was like, I mean, no. The only thing I really know, Mr. Burger, I haven't seen a lot of it, but the stuff I've caught has been like more of a quiz show, trivia type stuff. You know, he does like a weekly show doing that kind of thing. I haven't seen a whole lot of the animations. They're funny as hell. I like them. All right. Well, carry on then if it's just a trailer. I just want to make sure we weren't, you know.
Okay. All right. Here we go.
Through that, homie. I could have been better music.
Why, hello there, young lady. You look, in this bad lighting, after a few beers, you look very, very okay, I must say. I'm sure you get that compliment all the time.
Oh, my God.
Oh, thank you for the compliment, sweetheart. But I'm not God. If you come back to my place, though, you can experience a little bit of heaven.
I'm not interested. Thanks.
Yeah, yeah, I know. But your mouth says I'm not interested. But your eyes say get the hell away from me or I'll call the cops.
Listen, asshole. Haven't you heard of me, too?
Of course I've heard about that movement. And I have a question for you. Would you like some sex? Well, me too.
Look, douchebag, I'm not a real girl. I'm an alien.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't care how you got into the country. Viva la Mexico, if you know what I'm saying. No judgment here. So, how about we make some nice anchor babies and then you can,
That's
anchor babies.
Miles above the Earth, an alien spaceship hovers ominously in the cold darkness of space.
Ominously.
What the hell is going on here? Who are all these? What the?
Yeah, Charlie, this has been all a big mistake, so we're going to send you right back. You gotta get back to work, Daniel Prokof, these people.
Yeah, we talked it over the back, and we won't be interrupting you. To be frankly honest, you stink, and you appear to be very, very sweaty.
Here's the thing I don't understand, alright? You anal probed everybody up here, and you're not gonna anal probe me. Not that I don't want you to anal probe me, fair is fair, equality and all that, 2020, yo.
Honestly, you stink, and you appear to be greasy and sweaty.
I don't think my personal hygiene should enter into the discussion. You know, do your job. You're here to stick a metal thing up people's butts, and you might as well just do it.
You know what? If it will shut this idiot up, just put him on the table and let's get this over with.
Okay. Zappy, zappy.
Two metal tentacles come down from the ceiling and grab Mr. Burger. They move him across the room and slam him down on an alien exam table.
All right, you know, fair is fair. You know, if you're going to do it to everybody else, you might as well do it to me. Oh, my God, look at the size of that thing. Hey, what are you doing with that? What's going on? Listen. Hey, listen, I don't go for the rough stuff.
The enormous amount of pain causes Mr. Burger to pass out as the aliens make fun of his unusually small genitalia.
No.
Oh, it smells even worse now. Somebody get this guy out of here.
Okay. I had enough. Time to send this fat greasy idiot home.
The alien flying saucer makes his way to the Burger Town Mountains, just outside of the city limits.
Oh, my Lord. Oh, what the hell are you people doing?
It's not on Indiegogo. So is Mr. Burger on YouTube? Is that where all these come from?
Yeah, Mr. Burger's on YouTube.
John Malin like versus Mr. Burger, part two. Did you not? John Malin. Only on Choppy Ass Theater. And Fun My Comic.
Now we go to silent theater. Boobs. Uh-oh, that's going to make him mad. Uh-oh. Throbbing.
No.
That was part two, though.
Oh, shit.
Makes me wonder where part one is.
Yeah.
Mr. Burger, king of the anti-woke t-shirt.
That's cool. I love that stuff. I'm going to have to. I guess it's called Mr. Burger Phantom. Where is it at, Rex? Is it on FMC?
It's on Fun My Comic. It might still be over on Indiegogo as the trailer, but they have six backers, $160. 60 days left to go, 32% funded.
No, is this a comic book or a DVD or what? I'm confused.
Mr. Burger is everything you've ever wanted in an honest, straightforward, hilarious, on-point, non-politically correct superhero who is saying the things we're all thinking, except, you know, he's a cheeseburger.
Okay.
Digital membership card or a copy. This is a 32-page copy of the comic book, soft curler, $20. Hamburger.
Okay. So it is a comic
book. Yeah. It's a comic book. Yeah. Bacon, double cheeseburger, tier, Mr. Burger with everything. what's the everything for $65? You get Mr. Burger anti-woke t-shirt, choose your size, 12 by 16 poster, Burger Bunch digital membership card, a digital copy of the comic book, 32-page comic. A copy of the comic book softcover and 2-week early access to the all new Mr. Burger Show, a 30-minute animated cartoon.
Oh.
Part two, John Malin kicks everybody's ass. As the saga unfolds, Mr. Burger continues to discover Taco Bell trash strewn across his front lawn. Confronting his next door neighbor, John Malin. Okay. All right, I'll go with it. About the litter, because apparently Taco Bell litter is coming from John. Burger receives a denial, overreaching. Mr. Burger challenges John Malin to a boxing match, setting the stage for a showdown in the neighborhood. Oh, wow. Okay, so that must be the premise. John Malin kicks everybody's ass.
Oh, shit.
Let's see. Part one, Mr. Burger behind bars. In this episode, Mr. Burger, along with Rosedale and Joe Bag of Donuts.
Joe Bag of Donuts.
Oh, God, Rex. Killing me over here.
You're killing me. Enough of Mr. Burger. You've been cast. Oh, well,
okay.
Coming my way. My God. Anna, hey, Anna, bonsoir. I'm learning.
You got it right, soon.
Yeah. Oh, man. I'm sorry, but that's some overpriced looking
cat.
Yeah.
I'm clipping this. Fanta says.
Oh shit!
Wow. So this is directly tied in with John Mylan, apparently.
First it looks season, a lot like Donald DeLay's artwork on that. What was that one book called? I must have been Mr. Berger doing that with John too. There was a comic that just funded. Maybe it was part of that Mr. Berger thing. I'm not sure.
Oh, you got to be kidding here. Really? You got to be kidding. Let's watch the trailer.
Awaken to a world where personal identity shadows in comparison to digital reflections.
That's irritating.
Oh my God, that's what I think of it.
Abrupt stop.
All right, well,
I've already backed Artifice. Their $10,000 goal.
I don't know what's on
April 30th and runs to May 5th. Why such a short time?
What? Another campaign?
Yeah, and they're asking for $10,000.
Okay, I'm sorry, but I'm very confused with Artifice. It seems like it's been like nearly 4 years since this first launched, and like they've done like a couple, three campaigns already. Am I mistaken, or?
Well, I backed it a couple years ago. You know.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I could swear there's been another, like, a second chance and then a second chance. And
right.
I don't know. Yeah. I've lost so much track of where it's at and where it's going. Whatever. See, Tree Goblin's just asking, this is funding again? Am I mistaken, Tree Goblin? It's got to be, what, the third, fourth time now?
Yeah, back it because there's a Vantelican trading card as a stretch go. They got a stretch go. Well, the stretch go is getting $10,000.
Fanta, as much as I love you, dear. I backed this thing when it first came out.
Yeah, and Fanta did too when I backed it. There's a stretch go. If they hit 6,000,
was I really stoned last night, or did I see somebody saying something about Manticore was Captain Infinity's kid?
Wow, you must have been stoned, but it could be true.
I swear I saw somebody in chat say something.
I doubt that that's a thing because he's probably shooting.
No, I don't believe it's true. I just
he's probably shooting blanks anyway. He couldn't even make a manticore.
Oh, damn.
Fight me.
Fight me. I'll fly out from Australia. Be a man.
it lands.
You know I love you.
Crimson Skies. I will be having an ad, not on these. This is in Euros. It's Lemon's book here, Crimson Skies. I think this is 1 through 3. I think my ad, my Devil Flyer ad, will be in issue 4. I definitely want to get one of those. Let's take a look at the trailer. Oh, cool. Yeah, exactly. What is happening? I don't know any more about the book than what I did coming in. but he does have a good description here about the book, about the books. Actually, it's 1 through 3.
That's what I was supposed to do today. Damn it.
Oh. What did you need to do today?
I was supposed to read my Tome of Reckoning number 1 and 2, and I didn't get a chance yet. So.
Ah, you've still got time. Kami Mark's book here, Kim 2, Sung in Best Korea, 2024 mm-hmm. anniversary edition. Oh, wow. This is the day for wild trailers. So let's watch it.
Greetings, comrades, and welcome to Best Korea TV News. Today is yet another awesome day here in Best Korea as the infamous Western comic book writer who calls himself the Gay Space Jesus announces new book, The Adventures of Kim Il-sung in Best Korea.
That was horrible audio. I don't see how this sells books, but there you go.
The book is controversial in the West as using real undoctored photographs, it details the true historical outcome of the Korean War, our total dominant victory over the imperialist American dogs. Writer Kami Mark, the creator of Not Daredevil, seen here on YouTube show Gay Space Communism, has come under fire from the bourgeoisie capitalists for daring to speak the truth about how awesome everything is here in Best Korea with this tell-all 30-plus page comic. And how the eternal leader and all-round nice guy Kim Il-sung is actually magic and the rightful ruler of all of Korea. To celebrate such a momentous occasion in the history of Best Korea, almighty leader Kim Il-sung has moved the heavens and the earth to declare the month of February will be extended by one day.
To celebrate the genius and bravery demonstrated in honoring my grandfather and the mighty Kim dynasty, we the people of Best Korea here for and henceforth recognize February the 29th as Kami Mark Day.
Street parties are expected throughout the streets of Pyongyang as the Indiegogo campaign launches at midnight February 29th. The comic will be available in 2 formats in both standard US and a more traditional Korean manga style for the low price of just 10,800 North Korean won, $12. Check out the Indiegogo campaign for more details.
I get it. That sound just hurts my head.
Yeah, I just don't think bad audio helps the trailer, do you?
No, I don't know. There's something about it that just kind of hurts my brain. I don't like the...
Carrie looked it up. It's $6,500 U.S., but if they can get another $6,500 out of this campaign, I hope they do.
Santa looked it up.
Yeah. Mark did tinfoil covers. Yes, bring in the tinfoil age. He wrapped his books in tinfoil, didn't he?
Yeah. I mean, fucking Tommy Mark's a nutbag, man. He's funny as shit.
Yeah, but I wouldn't put bad audio on my trailer.
Well, dude, he's going to do his thing. Everything that he does, yeah, like Tree Goblin saying, it's all meant to be kind of terrible. I don't know. Okay. That's
kind of like communism. Oh,
yes, exactly.
We need the palate cleanser. That actually a good trailer. How about Octopus Cowboy? And I even skip out the shooting bit and just do the music. There we go.
Legend.
He's Battle the Shark. Wrestle the gorilla. Stomp the hyena. And that was before he had a gun. Most dangerous sacrifice in the worst. Is back.
Yes, you dance. Dance, monkey, dance.
It seems like a guitar, but it sounds so heavy metal. The movie, I don't know.
Some say he's just man. Some think it impossible, and I think some just him could exist. This is back to class. He's turning the page. Wants to get out of the slate. Breaks out of his cage. Don't get it mad. Don't get it wrong.
Cowboy, that's absolutely one. I would back to the hilt if I could.
And that's still in demand, correct?
Yes, still in demand. Yes, on Indiegogo.
Only on Indiegogo.
Olio, did you Google? We're talking about Fund My Comic.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, he's not on Fund My Comic yet.
No, hopefully but, we can get and I'm trying to get a hold of him through Snuggy Jr. and some other people to have him on here. We actually had Tommy Mark on here last year, maybe.
Yeah, it was a while back.
It's a while back, yeah, but it wasn't that far back. DVB in the house, aka Citizen 333. How are you? We need to set up that time that I can come on your team. Because you know, I'll be starting back to work here, and I don't know what time, you know. And I need to go on some channels, more channels. I need to run myself ragged and die an early death. Anyway, over on Fun, My Comic, you can find Fun. Remember Fun, F-U-N?
No. I don't remember.
It's the only place you can find Devil Flyer.
I vaguely remember something that used to be called Fun, but it's been so long.
Just whisper it in Mama Hawk's ear. She'll remind you.
Bad, bad boy.
That's what she said. Okay, follow man number two. We really have.
Yeah, DVB. Hold on. Rex DVB is asking you a question. He said the other night you convinced him to get back on Twitter. So he did. He followed you and he messaged you, and you still haven't even followed him back yet. You lazy bastard.
I never got the message. What are you under, DVB? What are you under?
Well, probably DVB.
I don't, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds great. That sounds great. This is a wonderful project. Hey, Anna, I'm back. Switch from PC to phone. We're glad to have you back, Anna.
Well, once again, then.
Follow Man 2 looks awesome. No trailer, unfortunately. And it's slow to load. Everything must be, you know, TIFF files or something. It's always slow to load every time I come on here.
Oh, but, he's a Citizen DVB, right? So a combination of the... there you go.
I'll just try and look it up under that right now.
You do it now. You do it now.
If I try to get it later, what did he say?
Well, you don't need to. If I don't do it now, I forget. So I either have to write it down immediately.
Exactly. Citizen.
Which reminds me, after we end the stream, I gotta go jump on Amazon.
You wanted to ask me something too. Do you remember what it was?
Yeah, that was last night. No, I have another mission.
Now, see, I put that in there, and it's like I don't get it. I do a search. No results found for at Citizen DVB. Or am I doing take the at out? Is that it? I'm challenging. No, I don't know. And since I'm not following back, if you can even. Anyway, I will be doing Apex After Dark tonight.
Is that 8 o'clock Central or 9 o'clock?
I stream every the Creatorverse streams every day at 5 p.m. Central. What day works for you? Any day.
Well, we might have to do a co-stream 5 p.m. We're usually streaming till 6.
Right. I mean, we could always cut it short or stream early on Eastern time.
Yeah, or co-stream, you know, to a multi-channel thing.
Mm-hmm. I thought I was getting some code shoulders. No, you weren't. I just refollowed you again, Fanta. It's me. Fanta, could you send me his? I don't know. I'm trying to get a hold of it. I don't know, man. I'm a needy person. Anyway, you mentioned something about getting out of here early, and I know you're busy, and I have tragic meatloaf to eat as well. I may do a stream later. Oh, I am doing a stream later with Apex. I have to remember that. Okay. Put that in my little brain. I will. I just need a little rest. Anyway, keep collecting, and we can see you later. Fanta, give me that contact with DBB if you would, if you can. I don't know. We'll set it up. We'll get there.
All right. Hey, hello. Love you, everybody.
Apex didn't even follow me back. Well, there's something seriously going on there. Something. DVB. Okay. Well, all right. So.
Yeah, no, bro. I didn't get anything either. So if you sent anything to me, I'm going to look as well.
On Twitter. Okay. Let me see this.
You probably didn't even send nothing to me.
Thanks for dropping that link in the chat. There we go. I am now following you and I'm sending you a message. Hey, Rex, I got back on X Twitter. You are going to follow me back. Okay.
Yo.
There we go. All right. Now you're top of the heap, DBB. Thanks, Fanta, for that. That's a lifesaver. Trust me. It really is. I did a search. I couldn't find it. You say no, that was under DVB. All you had to do, I guess I should have done a search for DVB. See, that ad, whatever, doesn't really matter. It's the name you're under. DVB.
The ad is just because you're sending it through Twitter.
Yeah, you could always check. You're welcome. Yes,
you don't have to put the ad in.
Exactly. But it wasn't.
Oh, cool. All right. I will definitely, if I'm not already sub to you, DVB, I will.
It wasn't under Citizen DVB, though.
Oh.
It was under just DVB.
Just DVB? Oh, okay. Well, either way, I'll find it.
I
have a specific set of skills.
Maybe that's why. Yeah, just found you on there, Shadow. Now he has Shadowhawk Talks and Shadowhawk Backs over there. Now which one is it? It's Talks, isn't it?
Talks on YouTube, Backs on Instagram, I think.
What about Twitter?
That's why we're talking. I'm not sure on Twitter.
Yeah, it's let me tell you. I know.
Shadowhawk's something.
It's Shadowhawk Talks. That's the one. You might do a search and you find Talks and Backs because he's got two accounts, kind of like I do. It's Talks that you want to send to.
Well, I used to be Shadowhawk Backs for like 2.5 years, but then when I started co-hosting with Rex, I changed it to Shadowhawk Talks.
From now on, drop the link like I did, and people can just click it. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, you got a wrench.
Yeah, DVB's got a wrench. Okay.
Yeah, if you know how to use it. She got legs. You know the rest. Anyway, we're out of here. Bye bye.
Good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.
Ah, screw it.